to The Source here on Sauga 960. My name is Annie Koshy, and I'm so happy to be back here on another Saturday. And it is a shortened version of our show today because we've had a game on. But I'm so glad that you've tuned in, and I have a special guest in studio. If you do have a story that you want to be, you want told, or you have an event that you want mentioned, or you just wish to come in and talk to me, by all means, email us at info@sauga960am.ca, or you can drop myself a line on my Facebook page. We are on Tuesday. You can tune into The Source on Saturday and Sunday from 3 to 5 p.m. We cover events, people, and stories here at Sauga 960. And also, when we're doing our live shows and you hear me on air, if you wish to talk to me, you can call us at 416-640-0200. So in studio with us today, we have Jordan Lindo, who is an image guru. And what does that actually mean? Well, he helps people, 9-to-5ers and entrepreneurs, really connect with who they are and how they want to dress. Welcome to studio, Jordan.
Thank you for having me. I appreciate you reaching out. It means a lot.
I'm really interested to hear, because one of the first things that many people asked me when I said that I was having an image guru come on is, what is an image guru?
So, okay, I'm going to make it very simple for you guys. For me, an image guru is a blend of two different aspects of myself. So, a big part of who I am is the conscious side of me, right?
Right.
I'm very much into mindset, I'm very much into mental health.
Right.
And the second part of that is fashion. So, I very much love have a deep love for fashion. And what I've noticed is that both of those things actually blended together to create what is an image guru.
Right.
And so, it's interesting because what I've noticed in the fashion world especially is that there's a lack of consciousness or self-awareness or realness, quotes, I'm doing air quotes for those of you listening.
Right.
Because, you know, trends have kind of taken over, so.
Yeah, we're going to talk about that as fashion has changed and style has changed, but let's start with your journey and where you grew up, what was your background, and will eventually lead to where you are today and the work that you're doing. But let's start with where you come from and what your background has been in.
Okay, when you say background, you mean?
Did you go to school for image consulting, or what was your focus in terms of education, and how did that all come about? Was that a hobby?
Okay, that's a great question. So, for me, fashion has always been something that was like ingrained in who I was before I even knew what it was. And it's the same actually for, the mindset aspect of what I do. And, you know, from probably, I would say, middle school, I was always that guy that people would notice was, super fashionable. Like, I stood out noticeably. Because you have to imagine, at that age, right, your mom is probably shopping for you. You're going
right.
to Walmart. They're getting the cheapest thing. They're throwing it on you, and that's it.
Right.
However, I was very blessed that my father traveled a lot. He was a traveling musician. And he would go to different parts of the world, Europe, Asia, and live there and play. And when he came back, we were so blessed that he would bring clothing for us. Now,
right.
sometimes, it didn't always fit. Like, I had a pair of shoes that were, like, three sizes too big for me, but I wore them anyways.
Yeah, you grew into them eventually.
I grew into them. They were Nikes, right?
Wow.
So I had to wear them. And they were Nikes that you could not get here.
And they were Nikes in a time where Nikes were, like, prime property, right?
Yeah, exactly. If you had Nikes on in middle school, you were that guy.
You were made.
Yeah.
Because I think it was at that time we had all those discount brands and I think we were able to get up to Adidas. I think that was the brand that I was able to, but Nike was like premium
right? You came from a different part of town if you had some Nikes on.
Right. So you were always into fashion and dressing style, that sort of thing, right throughout your early formative years. Was there someone that you looked up to that really mentored you, or that you really looked up as a teacher or a guide in your fashion sort of journey?
So I got to make a little bit of a tweak to that statement, and this is largely what I want us to talk about. So what I noticed from a young age was I didn't know what fashion was, actually. What I knew was how to express myself through clothing.
Right.
And that's not what we would describe as fashion today.
Right. So one is what's trendy out there, and the other, as I feel, is how you make the trend.
Exactly. 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 And what most people think today fashion is a trend. Is, okay, I go to the store, what's on the mannequin? That's fashion, right? And so from a young age, and this is what all people in high fashion know, is the creatives create fashion because they are fashion,
right?
And that's what I was at a young age. I would put things on, I would try different things. I was very curious to see what colors worked with what. And, there was a lot of trial and error as I grew, and my style became more and more refined. My style was actually just a reflection of my own personal development as well.
Now, tell me, did you focus on anything in high school or university that was related to fashion? Because I know that you have another aspect of you, and that was that you took this artistic side of you into a photography realm.
Yeah, you know what? Photography kind of bloomed because there was a need for me to assist people. I didn't take any specialized courses in any of the gifts that I have, surprisingly enough. So my photography bloomed because a friend of mine needed photos, and I had a camera, right? I had bought a camera probably 3-4 years prior. It was just sitting there.
Right.
And so I picked it up, and I said, okay, let me see what I can do. I did the shoot. It went well, and then I said, well, maybe I can actually do this. And what I've noticed was, because I didn't have technical training, the way that I took photos was not so familiar, and people enjoyed that. People enjoyed that there was a bit of sauce.
Yes, I understand completely what you're saying, because I'm like you. I photograph from the soul, and there are people that are more particular about the technical details of how, when, lens, this, that, aperture speed and lighting angles and whatnot. And I just look at the scene and I know if that picture is going to work or not. And I click and it's over. It's done very, very quickly. And I'm able to capture things that usually even a client is very surprised with, because you're capturing it from an artistic perspective. And so I call myself an artographer and not a photographer.
Yeah, see, so you totally get what I am, man. That's exactly what it is. It's a blend of your gifts, your talent, and your... What's that feeling that you get when you're excited? Your excitement.
Yeah, it's your energy. It's the passion that comes, that you put...
Passion,
right?
You put for.
That into whatever it is that you're doing, and because of that, that colors every aspect of it. So let's start with... What were some of the challenges you faced as you moved? Okay, so you started into photography. What were some of the challenges that you personally faced from moving from photography into launching your business as a image guru?
Well, it wasn't just photography. It was also videography. And anybody who is in videography knows that it can be your bread and butter if you know where to go. And so that's what it was. It was exciting when I first got into it, and then it was like, it got to the point where I didn't want to do it anymore.
But what was the burnout spot?
So if you're listening, you've noticed a trend, and everything that I do is backed by passion. And so my passion started to wear out with videography, because what I was doing was no longer creative, and I'm a huge creative. I have to be in a space that allows me to create. And so I was doing seminars.
Became more work.
Yeah, it became more monotonous.
And I get that, because I think as an artist myself, I'm creating constantly. Mm-hmm. And if I had to do that regular 9-to-5 grind, even with the skills that I do now as an artist, I'm taking those same skills that I was doing in a 9-to-5 job, but I'm applying that in a situation in which I'm enjoying doing it, and therefore it doesn't feel like it's really working. We have in studio with us right now Jordan Lindo, who is an image guru, and he has been talking about his journey. So if you've just tuned in right now, you'll be able to hear the rest of our conversation. But Jordan, tell us, what were your parents' reactions when you decided to tell them that you wanted to go into being an image consulting image guru?
Well, I mean, it was Okay, so this is how the transition happened. So my mom wanted me to go to school for something solid, right? Like every parent out there. And so when I decided that I was going to, make money through photography and videography, she was kind of like, okay, I see that you're making money. It's not my, cup of tea. Like, it's not what I wanted you to go into, but it's okay. It's cool. It's fine. And so that made my transition into being an image guru that much easier because I already had my own business. So all I was doing was shifting what that business was. Now, how was that transition? It was okay. It was okay.
And they were supportive?
Yeah. Yeah, my mom is like the greatest on the planet. I say my mom because my father at this point was not living with us.
Right. And so in terms of advising someone who wanted to get started on a journey similar to what you've had, what would be the best advice, perhaps to your younger version of you, mm-hmm. or that you would give to someone who's in their late teens going into a university course or a college course, or someone who's in their 20s and are floundering, they're not quite sure where they want to head? What would be your advice to someone like that?
Okay, so are you speaking specifically to follow my journey or their own journey?
Well, either. Because it could be that someone is hesitating on whether they could go into the fashion line and whether it would be lucrative, because everyone's looking at what's going to be the best way to earn an income. And it looks so larger than life, right? A fashion stylist or a career, is it always easy? What are some of the pitfalls that they need to pay attention to as they get into this?
So the very first thing that they need to figure out is, what do you love more? Like, if you are 100% into fashion, then you should just be a stylist. A stylist is somebody who is in love with fashion, clothing, colors, and they don't want to take it any deeper than that. And that's pretty easy. You can go to school, you can take a course, you can do an internship. There's so many ways to be a stylist. Now, if you're like me and you like the mindset stuff and you want to dig deeper and you want to help people with confidence and you want people to show up with purpose, then that's when actually it dives more into the realm of image consulting. Because now you're like, okay, what's the image that you want people to see?
Right, and you're going to get deeper into this conversation later on, but we are going to take a short break right now, and when we come back, we are going to hear back from Jordan Lindo, who is our image guru, and he's in conversation with us here at The Source on Sauga 960. We're back, and we'd like to give you a warm welcome here back to The Source at Sauga 960. Now, as I've mentioned before, if you do have a story that you want told or an event and you want us to come out to it, by all means, email us at info@sauga960am.ca, or you can also call us at 416-640-0200. The Source is heard Saturday and Sunday from 3 to 5 p.m. and we're on repeat again, so if you've missed our show, you can listen to it again on Saturday and Sunday from 9 to 11, and on Thursday, one of our shows is repeated from 8 to 10 o'clock. All of our shows will be going on podcast, so they are available for you to listen at your leisure when you get time. We have in studio with us Jordan Lindo, who is an image guru, and I'm very happy to have you here. My first question, if you could please define it, what is the difference between an image consultant and an image guru? Because I didn't have that right the first time I spoke with you.
Perfect, yeah. So it's very simple. An image consultant doesn't dive as deep. So an image consultant may look at, what is it that you want to do in terms of your image? How do you want to project? Now, an image guru dives deeper. So an image guru will look at, how can we help you become more confident? So it's much more of a coach meets a stylist combined.
Why is that so important in today's day and age? Because my book, for example, delves really into inner energy. Mm-hmm. And when you're looking as an image guru, why is it so important that people look at and need a coach to look at what their internal is in versus in what they're putting on the external, which is the clothes?
Okay, so that's a really huge question. I'm going to see if I can like break it down.
Yeah, that's important because people don't understand the impact or the importance of what it is that you're doing and why it's so essential today in terms of brand identity.
Well, you hit the nail on the head. You said why. So a lot of people are showing up and, you know, a lot of people are wearing great outfits, but they don't even know why they're wearing it. And there's a big difference between a guy in a suit who understands why he's wearing that suit and another guy in the exact same suit who just went into a store and bought something off of a mannequin. The energy behind it is not the same. And so as an image guru, I dive deep into who are you, what's your identity, and how can we magnify that? A lot of people don't even really want to wear suits. Like, suits is not their thing, but they think that that's how they have to look if they want to project a certain thing. And so I really help people tap into how can they project whatever they choose to project authentically and organically through, you know, a lot of different modalities.
Has there been one client in particular that stood out in your head that you made an amazing breakthrough with?
All of them.
When does that happen? When does the light bulb turn on for them?
You know what? It's an interesting journey because every client, I know it's going to happen. It's just a matter of at what point is it going to happen. And so I'm always excited for that moment, and it's always different. Now, I can't predict it. I don't know how fast it's going to happen, but I know what's going to happen.
So let's talk about some practical things. In terms of fit, what should people be looking for?
That is my cardinal rule. Every client, I tell the same thing, and even family and friends, I say, fit is everything. If it doesn't fit, don't even bother with it.
And what do you mean by fit?
So whatever you put on has to fit like a glove. Like, look at this shirt. I know you guys listening can't hear.
I'm watching him, and it fits him like a glove.
There you go.
So it's like it's made for you or tailored for you.
Exactly.
So what happens if you like something and you've fallen in love with the color or the cut, but it's just either a bit too long or it's a bit too wide? Should you get it tailored?
So there's a few things you can do. Tailored, getting tailored is one major way to fix that problem. And if it's a situation where you cannot get it tailored, and you can't kind of, you know, finesse it in a way that works for you, do not get that thing.
Right.
As great as it is. It could be a Gucci shirt.
Just don't do it.
Don't do it.
For that label.
Because
okay.
If it's not...
All right, there, you heard it from the style guru. All right. The other point I wanted to ask is, what if people, now everyone's got an existing wardrobe, what can they do with that?
Okay, so that's actually one of the major things that I do. Is this a good time for us to get into it?
Absolutely. Best time ever.
So I do a closet clean out, and what that is I help people understand what is in their closet, what needs to go, what can stay, and how do we fill in the gaps.
Okay, so I would have a major problem here because I am such a clothes horse. I have to admit it. I have clothes for everything. Now, I know friends of mine who are as worse than me in clothes horse. So this is a shout out to you, Sheeps, if you're listening. She's got clothes from when she was like 10 years old, I think, still in her closet somewhere.
Yeah.
But I have clothes that rule was, if you don't use it in a year, get rid of it. But sometimes I don't use it this year, and next year then I need it, and it's there, and so I'm able to use it.
Mm-hmm.
And there's a variety of choice. Coming from a South Asian background, we have so many different types of events that we have to go to, and being a host and on in front of the camera often, it means that I have to be prepared to be wearing different things. And so there's the formals, there's the office wear, there's the business casual, then there's the Indian formal, the Indian casual, that, you know, in the Indian form, there's, you know, the sari, the salwars, and women generally, between the jewelry, the shoes, the handbags, the scarves, the accessories, etc.
Mm-hmm.
I have an exploded closet.
Okay, so you are one of the few people that get a pass. Not everybody is in that situation. Most people are actually not. But because in Indian Pakistani culture, it's like clothing is so rich and the fashion is so rich. There are the few people that I do give a pass to because it's part of their identity. It's part of how they express. And so in that situation, all I do is help them organize it in a way that is accessible and clean, right? Because this is the thing, just because you have a lot doesn't mean that it should be overwhelming. And I have the feeling that what you're saying is your closet is overwhelming.
Well, it would be overwhelming for a lot of people. I know how to handle it because mm-hmm. I know where every piece is, and I know that when I'm setting myself up to for an event or a meeting, I know what I want to wear to convey that, and I know all of the accessories and where they are. Mm-hmm. So for me, it is a 10-minute shopping trip into my closet. Mm-hmm. It's really a shopping trip because then I'm able to put the pieces together the way I want it.
That's hilarious.
But if you were to give a piece of advice to someone listening in right now, they're out shopping, what are some staple things that they should have in their closet?
Okay, so every person needs basics. Now, this is going to vary from person to person. Not everybody's basics are the same. But I'll break it down real quick for men and for women. So for men, you definitely want basic shirts. So I'm talking about t-shirts, I'm talking about dress shirts, I'm talking about crew neck sweaters.
Right.
I'm talking about, you could throw maybe one or two jean jackets in there, but that's now a little bit outside basics. But you need those basic things. And for ladies, it's the same, right? You need basic tops. And you want neutral colors to start. You want blacks, you want navy blues.
So these are sort of foundation colors.
Foundations.
And so you would suggest that having the foundation and then accessorizing with blazers or other colors in their accessories mm-hmm. in the form of a scarf or mm-hmm. shoes, mm-hmm. Handbags, that would then add the pop of color, and then you could be trendy without having to spend the money on the trends that are there for your core.
Well, the funny thing about trends is, and this will be really quick, you can get trends on clearance.
Right.
Like, I consistently get trends on clearance. Like, I'm talking about $300 items on clearance for like $10. It's
right.
just a matter of knowing when to shop.
Right. What's one more piece of advice before we go into a break with regard to what's a big no-no for women and what's a big no-no for men?
Big no-no for both men and women is wearing things that don't fit you, your body.
So that's your number one pet peeve.
That's the number one thing, honestly. It's very simple, but a lot of people break that rule.
How can you extend the wearability of something that you own in terms of either seasonal or going from 1 year to the next year? What is some things, blazers, things that you don't always... you're not hand washing them or washing them at home. What are mm-hmm. some of the things that people should think about?
Okay, so for this, one of the main ways to extend the longevity of your clothing is to make sure that you're not overwearing the same thing. So a lot of people wear the same thing over and over again. And if your closet is large enough, right, you should be cycling through. Now, if you're wearing the same, see, this is so deep. Like, this is why I say image guru, because every single thing that we do reflects back to who we are and our mentality. And so
right.
I'm trying
so,
not to dive too deep here.
Well, it's wonderful because you're touching upon things. If someone wants to really get a hold of you in terms of reaching you, how could they do that?
Okay, so the main way would probably be Facebook.
Okay.
So Jordan Lindo on Facebook.
Just spell it out for them?
Yeah, Jordan, and then Lindo.
And dropping you a message there would be able to, they would be able to get a hold of you?
Yeah, and then I'm also on Instagram as well, and that's Unite, U-N-I-T-E, dot infinity, I-N-F-I-N-I-T-Y.
You've been listening to Jordan Lindo here at The Source at Sauga 960. We are going to take a break right now and come back and we'll learn more and hear more from him on his styling tips. Stay tuned. You're tuned into The Source here at Sauga 960. You can hear us every Saturday and Sunday from 3 to 5 p.m. and again on repeat from 9 to 11 p.m. As well as that on Thursday, you hear us at from 8 to 10 p.m. We're just wrapping up our interview here with Jordan Lindo. And Jordan, I know that you've got a couple of events coming up here in the next couple of months. Tell us a little bit about that and where people can reach out to you if they want to be a part of that.
Okay, so first things first, the event is happening. It's a workshop. It's happening on May 16th, okay, 2020. And they can reach out to me on my social media handles. That's Jordan Lindo on Facebook. and that's unite.infinity on Instagram. And we're going to be covering a plethora of things in regards to fashion, accessories, what to wear, what not to wear, do's, don'ts. We're going to be making it visual. We're going to be making it engaging. So people who are showing up, it's not going to be a bore fest. It's going to be, like, exciting. You're going to want to be there. A lot of workshops, you know, it's very laid back. This is not one of those workshops.
And I think that's important for people to understand is that the importance of being able to brand your style is a reflection of your brand as a personal basis and also a company. So if you're an entrepreneur, mm-hmm. what's the impact of upping your style?
Oh, I mean, infinitely huge. Like there is no gauge. Like to me, it's like, what is a connection worth? What is anyone who's in network marketing knows that when you network and you make a new business partner, that could be worth anywhere from $1,000 to $1 million to $10 million. It depends on what market you're in. So I want you to imagine if you're now in the six-figure, seven-figure, eight-figure range, it gets exponentially more important. So
right.
For the everyday person, right, it could mean meeting a partner. It could be meeting a love interest. It could be meeting, you know, a new friend. So it all depends, right? But it's a huge, because when people look at you, there's a judgment that happens. And what happens is either they look at you as this is a potential friend, this is a potential business partner, or this is somebody that I don't even want to engage with. And so
right.
you can determine what that narrative is if you choose.
And this is wonderful. It's been a pleasure having you here in Studio Jordan, and it's been a great opportunity for us to get a glimpse into your world, which is really mm-hmm. quite complex. People mm-hmm. think fashion and styling is one thing, but being an image guru is really having a coach on your style. And if you've been struggling with your style, if you've been struggling mm-hmm. with your image and what you're putting out there, and you just need someone who's going to be able to coach you and encourage you both on what you're wearing, but also on how you're feeling, then those two things in combination is really what Jordan is doing. And you should really reach out to him and get a hold of him so that he can help you just streamline your personal image. So thank you so much, Jordan, for coming into studio and talking to us. It's been a pleasure. We look forward to hearing from you and also seeing the clients' feedback from you helping them throughout your work.
Thank you so much for having me.
And there you have it. You've been listening to Annie Koshy here on The Source here at Sauga 960. You're hearing us every Saturday and Sunday from 3 to 5 p.m. This has been a shortened version of our show today, but we will be back tomorrow, and it's a special day. It is Women's Day tomorrow, so I have lots of tips and tricks and things that I've been up to, but things that we're going to share and shout out for all the women around our beautiful world. Talk to you soon. Bye-bye.